Hi everyone, this is Candidate Master Isaac Steinkamp here with Chess Summit. I'm going now from my Airbnb to the St. Louis Rapid and Blitz to watch the last day of the Rapid and Blitz tournament here in St. Louis. Of course, you know, even though Levon Aronian has a pretty sizable lead over the field, it's going to be a pretty big day in terms of Grand Prix points. We saw Sergey Karjakin surge with 8 out of 9 yesterday. I think if he can beat Kasparov this morning in the first round of the day, then he's got a shot at giving Aronian a run for his money. But I wouldn't get too excited. I picked Karjakin actually to win the event overall, but I still wouldn't get too excited. I still think, as incredible as 8 out of 9 is to win this event, he's got to do a little bit more, but he's almost there. So I think that would be pretty interesting. I think another side story is how Garry Kasparov was struggling. I guess it really shouldn't be a surprise, but of course I picked him to be second, so I shouldn't be talking. It's just really tough to play against this field, I guess, when every single round you're playing is one of the best in the world. So what am I planning on doing this morning? Well, I've got a little media pass here, so I'm gonna get in a little bit early into the round. But before I do that, I'm hoping to get some breakfast and hit up the World Chess Hall of Fame. So hopefully I'll get some cool videos for you guys. So yesterday when I got here for the first time, it felt like every 5 minutes I had my mind blown. This is the world's tallest chess piece. It's 14 feet and 7 inches tall, 6 feet long diameter, so even if I were lying down next to it, it'd still be longer than me since I'm only 5'11". So this is the World Chess Hall of Fame. I'm going to check this out after breakfast. Right in front of me, I've got the Chess Club and the Kingside Diner, which is part of the chess campus here in St. Louis. So a lot of fun stuff to check out for today.
Dynamic. You can jump pieces and probably still lose on time.
It was pretty messy.
Yeah.
Also pretty hot.
Yeah. We're still kind of cooling down. We're heading now to the tournament hall with only an hour to spare until the start of the round. So we're going to go in there and see if we can get any good shots on any players.
Guys, I'm in the tournament hall right now. We're here an hour before the round. Eric's down doing a Twitter takeover for U.S. Chess Federation. Pretty exciting stuff going on, as I mentioned earlier. I think Karjakin versus Kasparov will kind of dictate how this tournament will go from this morning. If Karjakin can build up his momentum, that's pretty big news. So hopefully I'll be getting some video of that game for you guys, and it should be a fun last day for you. I'm going to go on a not-so-bold limb and say there won't be a playoff tomorrow. So we'll see how that turns out in just a little bit.
David, how do you feel about your tournament so far?
Okay, I haven't played very well. I made too many mistakes yesterday in the Blitz, and my play in the Rapid Chess was not particularly good either. But okay, I had some better moments, of course. But okay, I hope to play better than yesterday.
In particular, that you're doing differently today? It's the last day of the tournament? Or are you just going to treat the tournament like it has been so far?
Okay, I brought a chocolate bar with me, so I don't know, I want to play good chess, which would be different from yesterday's play.
Of course, well, good luck.
feels good in my heart, in my soul, when you're right here beside me. I don't ever want this day to end. We can watch the waves, have a coke, and just sit here beside me. I take a little of my heart again, so we can feel forever, yeah, feel together, be real together, and no one can stop me when I taste that feeling. Nothing could ever bring me down. To no one can stop me when I taste that feeling. Nothing could ever bring me down. You make it easier to sing, yeah.
Watching the first three rounds for today. A little bit surprised my Curry Atkins won B3, but I guess getting out of prep really worked because he wound up winning a pretty convincing game after Kasparov spent about an extra 30 seconds in the opening. That time margin never really disappeared. So Curry Atkins got a nice win, and then Navarro surprised everyone, the bottom feeder, beating both Aronian in a drawn rook and pawn ending, and then turning around and beating Curry Atkins as well. So definitely lucky that we caught him on a special interview there. We're gonna go into the Kingside Diner and check out the commentators on site here, Robert Hess and Varouz Jacobian. Let's go take a look. Just got out of the media house. Levon Aronian has just won the St. Louis Rapid and Blitz thanks to his round 25 draw against Gary Kasparov. There's two rounds left, so I'm gonna go ahead and take some last photos, as it will not be a playoff tomorrow, so this will be the last chance to see some of these top-notch players play in a major event. So I'm gonna go back into the tournament hall. With every fading sunset, we see the stars align. We make the simple moments last for a lifetime. So we'll feel forever. So you just finished up a long day here at St. Louis. How do you feel about your performance in the event?
I feel pretty well. I think I played quite well, especially in the Rapids, but also in the Blitz. I mean, from the chess, purely chess point of view, I think I did pretty well. I was having a lot of trouble with the time. So, but in general, I think overall it's fine.
What's your next tournament?
I'm not really sure because I'll take I think a long break already. I mean, from since last December, I've been just resting and preparing, so I will probably continue for this half a year probably.
What's one thing that you learned from participating in the Rapid and Blitz here in St. Louis?
Well, I think that you have to be somehow more practical in this time control. So I kind of knew it, but I now it's becoming more and more clear that it's really necessary to these days to be ready to do well in this fast time controls. And I guess I need a lot of more practice and training on that direction.
So you just finished the St. Louis Rapid and Blitz. How are you feeling after such a long tournament?
Feel a little bit tiring. In general, I think I played quite a solid tournament. I had a few good wins, a few lucky wins too, but a lot of missed opportunities. So, but that happens a lot in Rapid and this. So I think that's one of the things we have to improve in the future.
Talking about lucky, you went 3-0 against Caruana this tournament. How did it feel to be able to play against someone who also lives in St. Louis and do so well?
Yeah, that was a really nice result for me, and I didn't expect it from the beginning. Especially the Rapid game, I was extremely lucky against him. But I think that took this game, I played quite well and I won. So yeah, he's definitely a very strong opponent, and in this tournament maybe I got good results against him. But in the future tournaments, I'm sure he's gonna look for revenge.
What's your next tournament that you're competing in?
I'm going to Georgia for the World Cup, like everyone else here.
Right. Who are you playing in the first round of the World Cup, and how do you like your chances to go far into the tournament?
I'm playing Grandmaster Kunin from Germany in the first round. I think my rating is a lot higher than him, but it's not... I cannot always assume that I can win, but I will definitely try to be as well prepared as I can, and hopefully things will go better.
Feeling right now?
Well, I feel some relief because it was a really tough tournament for me, and okay, I wasn't as well prepared as I would like to, but I mean, okay, what's done is done, and you know, of course it's a great experience, and of course it's a great place to be and a great you know, event to participate, because I mean, it's again the finest players were all together here fighting, you know, every round. I mean, AFK was big fun.
You took fourth place here in the Rapid and Blitz. Are you happy with your final result?
I'm very unhappy because I messed up so many chances, especially in Rapid, and I mean, maybe I was like a little bit disappointed for my Rapid performance, and I couldn't show even something close to my best in Blitz. I mean, just doing okay, I finished off days with plus one. I mean, but this is absolutely nothing because I mean, in a, you know, in some good condition, it should be like 8 out of 9 here. But well. That's you know, that's also a part of sport, that you should to try to bring yourself in your best shape to there, you know, to the most important tournament. But it looks like I didn't manage to do this. But I mean, once again, what done is done, so it could be far better. But to tell the truth, it could be worse because I mean, once again, I was far from my best condition.
You were the first player in the field to beat Garry Kasparov. How did it feel to be the first player to take him down after all the hype?
Yeah, I mean, okay, it felt really well, but once again, it's just one game out of, you know, out of 27 in this Rapid and Blitz. And of course, it's a great honor for me to play against Garry for board, you know, in live, not in the internet. So, there is no doubt, I have some special excitement, especially the first time when you meet him. But, I mean, you know, I would probably... I mean, I wouldn't be less happy when, you know, if I managed, you know, to end my other my games in some logical way, you know, instead of beating some. Okay, it's great. Once again, it's great to beat Garry, but I mean, it was very, very complex game and very fighting, and but it's also good, you know, to win some, you know, plus four, plus five, plus three, and it was like in the rest games like twice a day or something. It was something like this, and okay, it ruined. I even lost in the last round at the winning position to Naka. So, right now, I mean, it's a little bit... I'm still under pressure of this, unused chances.
All right, well, thank you so much.
Well, that puts an end to the St. Louis Rapid and Blitz. It was a really fun tournament to report, even though I was only here for the Blitz portion of the tournament. I'm heading down now for the Ultimate Moves at 3, so I'll have some more photos for you then. But until then, it's been a lot of fun. I've met a lot of really great people, a lot of readers of Chess Summit, and a lot of really great chess players. So it's been quite a fun weekend, and I'm hoping I can come back in the near future.